I went and visited the NLA's 3D London model at Guildhall. It maps most of Greater London to impressive accuracy and provides an exciting physical glimpse into the future of the city. By including buildings that have planning permission, this model shows how London and its multiple skylines might look in future. So here's the city, Canary Wharf, Vauxhall, and of course, the Shard. It's a 1 to 2000 scale model with 240,000 buildings across 200 square kilometres of the city. The map demonstrates just how much change is happening all across London. It also highlights how London's transport network is helping to shape its skyline, with clusters of tall buildings at Elephant and Castle, Bankside, London Bridge, and the City of London, all sitting at key interchanges on the tube network. And that is by design. Enabling as many people to easily access London's transport network has been a central pillar of planning policy here for over 100 years. And one of the key objectives of the Jubilee Line when it was extended eastwards in the 1990s was to encourage the development of acres of derelict land across the parts of East London that it passes through. And almost 30 years later, this vision is becoming reality, with Stratford, Canning Town, North Greenwich, Canary Wharf, and Canada Water all seeing huge levels of development spurred on by access to the Jubilee Line, creating this forest of skyscrapers that have brought life into formerly derelict areas. The model really highlights what a sprawling metropolis London is becoming, with these clusters of skyscrapers poking out of the urban blanket. It's not just one city, it's loads of different cities merged together. It kind of reminds me of Tokyo, which is also a city of cities, and has these clusters of skyscrapers scattered across the urban fabric, again at key transport interchanges. And that's great because taking lessons from one of the world's most efficient and livable cities is probably a positive thing for London. There's also a second model which focuses more detail on the very heart of the city, so you can see how London's tallest proposed skyscrapers will look when they're eventually built. I'll put on the screen a little bit more information about each of these. Many of you watching this video will probably remember when London's skyline had very few tall buildings. So to see this and realise that actually a lot of these buildings already exist must be quite a lot to take in. Tower 42 was the tallest building in the city when it opened in the 1980s, but now it's been swallowed up by taller buildings. And the city's proposed new tallest building will be about 70% taller than Tower 42. Now, I'm going to be honest, I think this is a far cry from what some of these buildings were going to look like when they were originally proposed. But for whatever reason, plans have changed as the years have gone on, and these are the buildings we'll see going up in the coming months and years. I still think a lot of these buildings are cool, especially this one with the diamond-like facade. The plan also shows a notable lack of tall buildings anywhere near St Paul's Cathedral. Views of this iconic landmark are protected, which prohibits anything too tall from being built in its immediate vicinity. And one more thing to mention on the big map is this line, which represents the Bakerloo Line extension. Just like the Jubilee Line in the 1990s, this is proposed to unlock underdeveloped parts of the city, to build new homes and new places. As the line snakes through southeast London, we can see how it's already attracting development, with new clusters of tall buildings proposed adjoining each station to take advantage of the improved connectivity. So we might see this part of London transformed in a similar way to East London over the coming decades. That's all we have time for today. I didn't get paid for this, I just really like this model and I wanted to show you all why. I like how it represents London's past, present and future. You can visit the model yourself for free, and I'll put the important information on screen and in the description. Thanks for watching, have a great day, and see you in the next video.